and welcome to the third in our series of solo Bach recitals at the Proms. Tonight, we're in for a huge treat. The celebrated and world-renowned pianist Andras Schiff will play Bach's Goldberg Variations. This is a titanic masterpiece of the Baroque period, one of the most complex and ambitious pieces ever written for keyboard. Bach himself was a deeply religious figure, but he was also a virtuoso player. And for this, he mined deep into his imagination to explore a whole range of styles and techniques for this secular work. Sir Andras Schiff has played Bach all his life. Earlier, I caught up with him to discuss his long relationship with the Goldberg Variations.
Do you remember the very first time you heard the Goldberg Variations?
Yes, very well. I was maybe 12 years old, and somebody gave me on a Russian pirated record. I was living in Hungary, so Glenn Gould's first recording.
The Canadian, yeah.
Yes, and that impressed me so much. And I always said, oh my God, will I ever be able to play this?
And was it the Goldberg Variations that started your love affair with Bach?
No, the love affair is much longer. I always loved Bach. The Brandenburg Concertos, the St. Matthew Passion, things like that, yes. So the Goldbergs came later.
I read that you start every single day playing Bach.
Yes, it's exactly like that. Every day, it's like a ritual. It lifts my spirits and it also saves me from doing stupid mechanical exercises, which I thoroughly dislike. If I start with Bach, it cleanses the spirit, it cleanses the heart, the mind, and it also gives me this physical pleasure of movement.
Why is this piece actually called the Goldberg Variations?
Well, it's a legend that there was a diplomat in Saxony, Count Kaiserling, who was formerly ambassador to Russia, and he suffered from insomnia. He couldn't sleep. And he had a court harpsichordist by the name of Goldberg, who was 14 years old, who studied with Johann Sebastian Bach. And so the Count asked Goldberg to ask the master to write a piece for him to soothe his spirits on these sleepless nights. And so this is the story, and then Bach thought he would write this aria with 30 variations, and the Count, when he couldn't sleep, he would call Goldberg that, please Goldberg, get up and play me one of my variations. This is the legend.
It starts with a lovely aria and finishes with that, and there's this journey in between.
Yes, it's a journey, and it's so, because the beginning and the end are identical or almost identical. They form a perfect circle. So it's a circular concept.
Bach's music has been described as sort of mathematical and very structured, but where is the emotion in it? Where does the emotion come from?
When I say mathematical, I mean it as a compliment, because I'm not very good at mathematics, but I love it, and I know that there is a beauty and a poetry in it. So, yes, there is an intellectual element in Bach, but there is a huge emotional range in it. This is a very religious person. Mm-hmm. Religion is very important.
But this is a secular piece.
It is a secular piece, but by a very religious composer. And religious, I mean, it's not a limitation, but a liberation. And you can be of any religion, you can even be an atheist, but at the moment when you are playing Bach, you have to get on that wave. Otherwise, don't even try it.
Though you're now going to play this in the Royal Albert Hall, which is what, the biggest venue you've played the Goldberg Variations in?
Certainly.
So what are you thinking about that? What's the challenge?
It's a huge challenge because it's a very large venue. There will be thousands of people there. And yet I have to make them think that they are in a living room. And I have to feel like I'm in my own living room. This is very intimate music. Some of it is very virtuosic, but most of it is very confessional. Mm-hmm. A confession is basically a solitary affair between you and the person you are confessing to. So it's not really public. But this is a wonderful opportunity because somehow in your own world you can change the world for about 70 something minutes. Mm-hmm. I don't know what was before or what will be after, but this is something magical.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
That was Sir Andreas Schiff playing Bach's Goldberg Variations. A mammoth undertaking. 75 minutes of intensity and virtuosity. As Bach wrote, this piece was composed for music lovers to refresh their spirit. Well, that's all for tonight. If you want even more Bach, you can join me next Thursday on BBC 4 as our Bach recital series culminates with the magnificent American virtuoso Yo-Yo Ma performing Bach's suites for solo cello. But for now, from me, Kirsty Wark, and everyone here at the Royal Albert Hall, a very good night.